epic concerts. I actually got to open for the Beach Boys and for Kenny Rogers right in the same building. Right in the same. You know, one time for my wife Bonnie, isn't she something? From the moment that I was aware that she was on this planet, I've been head over heels in love with this woman, and now you know why. And you know, people ask me, they say, you know, what is the single greatest resource that we have here in the Big Sky Country? And I can tell you without a shadow of a doubt, it is our strong, smart, intelligent Montana women. We've been working very hard through this whole election. I think that from the time that I declared my candidacy and threw my big and well-traveled hat into the ring, we have actually been out to 49 different counties. We've been making a personal connection with everybody, and I just have to say that how you run this election is how you're going to run the office. And so to me, it's been very important to reach out to all these places that I've played music in, but haven't had a chance to really talk with them about the problems that are facing Montana and America today, and it's just been such a great honor for me to get out and meet all of you. It's so good to be here tonight. Thank you. You know, when I first started this, I think probably one of the reasons I got into this, and as Bonnie mentioned, this was something I had to search my soul to think about, but it really came down to a quote by Ernest Hemingway that our lives are measured by the magnitude of the challenges we accept. And I realize that there can be no greater challenge than representing the state of Montana, but given my love for the Big Sky Country, it's one I've had to accept. It's one I've had to accept. I think the number one issue for me when I first got into this is the fact that the forces, I recognize that there are forces in this country that have ill designs on our beloved state of Montana. And my opponent is one of them. He blocked stream access on the East Gallatin River and tried to sue the people of Montana to eliminate stream access. No Montanan would ever do that. No Montanan would do that. But even more importantly, he gave thousands, tens of thousands of dollars to groups whose sole goal it is to transfer our public lands into private hands. You know, people like Jim Forte, when they see our mountains and streams, they probably think, well, that would be great to own and fence in and develop. But real Montanans would say, this is our way of life. Fishing in the big hole of the Yellowstone. Chief Seattle said many years ago, we do not inherit the earth from our ancestors. We borrow it from our children. There can be no greater truth in regard to this beautiful landscape. And the transfer and eventual sale of our public lands is nothing more than theft against our children and our grandchildren, and I promise you, I will steadfastly defend it. You know, some of the happiest people I know are those who spend the most time in Mother Nature, and sometimes when I see someone who is a little depressed or a little angry, I think, well, you should take a walk in the mountains. And on a side note, I think Montana, it's time to tell Montana to tell that other guy to go take a hike. You know, there's a group of 40 writers that have put together a composite of how they feel about our public lands. And this is going to be circulated, and I'm so honored that they're backing me in this. And I want to share with you a poem that I wrote about how I feel about this big sky country. Would you like to hear my poem? Montana. She's been called a lady when we sing her praise. And if you fail to see the logic, well then, let me count the ways. Her cirrus hair is red and gold at evening sunset's light. And I've always thought her mountains looked especially good in white. Her gown is luscious green when she attends the annual springtime ball. And she fancies orange and gold at harvest moon in the fall. Her wild and natural beauty, it will take away your breath. Oh, but just take her for granted. It could easily mean your death. She's slow to grant her favors to come lately, newer faces. To longtime suitors, she reveals her hidden secret places. She lives in big time splendor. She's the heart of the Golden West, and all manner of wondrous creatures live and suckle at her breast. And yes, there will be those who come with schemes of ways to use her, to sell her body like a harlot, to cheapen and abuse her. If you've sworn your love for her, revere, respect her. If you're a man of honor, you must cherish and protect her. And should we fail in this task, we'll lose this living treasure. Should we prevail, this lady that we love will live forever. I think public lands were the number one issue until the House passed this disastrous health care bill, and this came screaming up as the number one issue in this race, and with good reason. This is not a health care plan. They call it the American health care plan. I call it the un-American health care plan. This isn't a health care plan at all. This is merely a tax break for the super rich. That's all it is. It would raise premiums on the average citizen by over $300. It would also be an age tax for those between 50 and 64 years of old age, paying 5 to 6 times as much as everybody else pays. And of course, once again, it brings back pre-existing conditions. Half of all Montanans have pre-existing conditions. How many of you would have a pre-existing condition of this? There is the proof right there. There is the proof right there. And once again, special tax breaks for not only millionaires, but insurance company executives. Does anybody else think this is a good idea? No. You know, I've had my health care issues, and that's been well documented. But the thing is that to me, I've lived life on the ground. I've gone through this, we paid our bills, we powered through, and we didn't declare bankruptcy. But in the greatest country on earth, people should not have to declare bankruptcy just because they have a health issue. And let's talk about women's issues. To me, women's issues, these are women's health or reproductive rights. We should all resist the assault on women's reproductive rights. Are community issues and family issues and human issues. And I support access to birth control and preventative screenings. I promise you that I will oppose any effort to defund Planned Parenthood. You know, politicians like Gianforte have no business getting in the way and making decisions which should be between a woman and her faith and her doctor. I support a woman's right to choose. all for coming out today, and I know that as I look out in the crowd, I see that I've made a personal connection with many of you, and we have sat together and we have shared our hopes and our concerns and our dreams for the future of this land and this life. But I know that if we stand together, we cannot be denied. We cannot be denied. And today, more than ever, we must stand and unite and hold our leaders accountable. This should be an awakening, not only for the people of this nation and for Montana, but for everyone. You know, I promise you that when you feel like your voices are being drowned out by critics and bullies, I will stand behind this microphone to make your voices heard. So I'm asking you to stand with me, Montana, and I will stand up for you.